The 49ers hosting the Cleveland Browns live from Candlestick. And welcome to the broadcast booth, everybody. Ian Eagle along with Hall of Famer Dan Fouts. Great to be with you. The Browns and the 49ers, San Francisco, one of the biggest surprises in the NFL this season, Dan. And Cleveland improved from a year ago, but still trying to find itself offensively at this point.
Well, the Niners, it's football Harbaugh style.
Yeah.
Great running attack led by Frank Gore, over 100 yards in each of the last three games, and a solid defense led by Patrick Willis. For the Browns, two words, Ian: fast start. Colt McCoy and the Browns only got 3 points in the first quarter all year long, and they'll get the ball to start this ball game.
Cleveland at 3-3, San Francisco at 5-1, and the weather to open things up. You can't ask for a better day. 72 degrees, sunny skies in the forecast for the rest of the afternoon. San Francisco did win the toss, but they have deferred to the second half. And David Akers will get things started here at the stick. Josh Cribbs, the deep man, and Cribbs is going to take it out. Or is he? Takes a knee, thinks better of it. And Cleveland will have it at the 20. Here's it from the fans who actually wanted to see some extracurricular activities on special teams. Colt McCoy, so far as a starter in his young NFL career, he's 5-9.
And as I said, Ian, it's important for the Browns to get started quickly today. All season long, they've had trouble in this first quarter. Important for McCoy to keep in mind not to press, let the flow of the game come to him. If he makes a mistake, let it go, play freely.
And a double tight end set to open things up with Watson and Smith from the 20-yard line for Cleveland. And McCoy on a handoff. It's Hardesty getting the call and nothing there. Ray McDonald, first man to greet him. 1 yard gain for Montario Hardesty. Take a look at the starting offense for the Cleveland Browns. Up front, they've got a former 49er manning that right tackle position. Tony Pachos, the 31-year-old veteran. Backs and receivers, Peyton Hillis out once again because of the hamstring injury. So Montario Hardesty in his second year out of Tennessee getting the start. Hardesty had 95 yards on the ground last week in a 6-3 win over Seattle. McCoy to throw it. No, he loses the football. Ahmad Brooks got in there and then a fight for it. Sopoaga comes away with it. And San Francisco creates a turnover. First series of the day.
Well, this is 15 takeaways now for the 49er defense on the year. Great start. A helmetless linebacker, Ahmad Brooks, comes in with the big hit, knocks the ball loose, and there's Isaac Sopoaga with the recovery. Great start for the 49ers, and another disastrous start for the Cleveland Browns. Watch the pass rush here by Ahmad Brooks. Gets inside Pachos there, and then a direct route to the quarterback, McCoy. He did not have a shot, a chance, in anything to keep this ball down the field.
Well, the concerns for San Francisco, momentum that they had heading into the bye week after that 25-19 win over Detroit. Where would there be complacency for this 49er team? They get it done on defense to start things off. Crabtree and Ginn, the receivers, on a 1st and 10 from the 20 for Alex Smith. Off the turnover. Handoff to Gore, and he sticks his helmet down and carries for 4 yards to the 16. Chris Gokong there defensively for Cleveland. Alex Smith, is he a different guy than the one we saw in the previous 6 years? He's certainly playing with a lot of confidence.
Well, this is his 7th year. He has matured, and he appreciates Harbaugh's attention to detail. And being a self-admitted perfectionist, he wants to be a 49er. I think that's really key. He wanted to be here to be the quarterback for Jim Harbaugh.
And prior to this season, 51 touchdowns, 53 interceptions. So far this season, 8 touchdowns,
keep it good.
2 picks, limiting the mistakes. And a timeout taken by San Francisco. So we'll step aside, just on turnover, but he took a shot on that sack from his own man, Justin Smith, who was coming in from the other side. Colt McCoy coughed it up, San Francisco trying to take advantage. Braylon Edwards in the game, he's back off the knee injury. And a 2nd and 6. Smith looking in that direction. Knocked around. And almost picked off. And then almost caught by Edwards.
Can you say pinball? Because that's what this one was. A slant route to Braylon Edwards. Edwards at just four catches on the year from the right side of the screen. You'll see him come in here. Ball thrown behind. And then just about everybody had a good shot at it. Scott Fujita actually had the best shot at it. Right there. And now Edwards has a shot at it. He gets it knocked out.
Hey, you want to go all the way out?
So a third and six. Smith will work out of the gun. Smith fires, broken up. Good play there by Joe Hayden. Penalty marker thrown. Two of them. Hayden in a matchup with Michael Crabtree.
They're going to say Hayden was just a little bit too early on this. Kind of grabbed the back of Crabtree's jersey.
23 defense. First down, spot of a foul.
Referee Bill Levy filling us in. That's a huge call.
Yeah, it's a slant route again. It's probably one of the basic routes for this West Coast offense for both ball clubs today. You can see the right hand was dragging Crabtree to the ground as the left hand was playing the ball.
Hayden, who is playing with a sprained knee, number 7 pick in last year's draft. And it gives San Francisco a first and goal just inside the 10. Smith on a gear for Gore. Up the middle, and Gore squeezes through inside the 5, hit by Mike Adams in a 5-yard gain. Let's take a look at this San Francisco offense protecting Alex Smith. Mike Iapati, nothing but raves on that left side in his second year from Idaho. And backs and receivers. Ted Ginn got the start. Ginn is a Cleveland native, but we've seen Braylon Edwards already on this first series.
75 and 90 eligible.
Sopoaga is in. He's on the right side of that line. Handoff, Gore, stutter step, and Gore takes it into the end zone for the touchdown. Penalty marker on the play.
It's going to be against Cleveland.
12 men on defense. Penalty is declined. Touchdown.
What a start here for San Francisco. The turnover, and they quickly turn it into a score.
And they, even 12 men can't stop Frank Gore getting into the end zone one more time. Just a blast play right up the middle. Iapati, as you talked about, Ian, coming on the pull there, really had nobody to block. Horrible start for the Browns. A turnover and then 12 men on a touchdown run.
Fifth rushing touchdown of the season for Frank Gore. David Akers on for the extra point. Ryan Jennings to snap it. Punter Andy Lee holds it. And a 7-0 lead for the 49ers. A lot of people waiting for the Powell Street cable car in San Francisco, one of the great cities in America. 49ers have been one of the great teams in the league so far this season, doing it with their defense to open things up and then converting on offense for a 7-0 lead. San Francisco kicking it off with Akers to Cribbs. Takes it on the move from the 1. Cribbs cutting it to the outside and chopped down as he crossed the 30-yard line. Good return by Cribbs. Anthony Dixon on special teams making the play. So Colt McCoy will try to put that one out of his head, which has been difficult. His head coach Pat Shurmur said that's one thing they've been working on with him, trying to move on from mistakes. Take a look at the San Francisco defense. Justin Smith, the veteran presence. He's really emerged as one of the leaders. Linebackers, what a season Navarro Bowman is having. Last year special teamer, this year leading the team in tackles. And in the secondary, Dante Whitner, he's a Cleveland native as well, and he's added a big boost to this roster. Spin move by Hardesty. A lot of responsibility on Hardesty's shoulders now. 4-yard gain with the injury to Peyton Hill as Hardesty carried the football 33 times last week. Cleveland dominated the time of possession against Seattle. Held the ball for 42 minutes and 56 seconds. It's the highest for a Browns team since 1976.
And Pat Shurmur said he was sore at the beginning of this week, but being as young as he is, got over his soreness after those 33 carries.
Second and 5, McCoy. Out of the pocket, pump fake, and a slide by McCoy that's short of the 45-yard line, but it is enough for the first down. Before the game, we kept an eye on Peyton Hillis. And Hillis trying to bounce back from the hamstring injury, but basically there was no indication that he was going to be able to give it a go. He didn't make the trip out here.
I didn't see his wedding ring, though, there, Coach.
Yeah, he did get married earlier this week. Good info from you on Tuesday. Chris Obanaya, in his second year in the NFL, out of Texas, formerly with St. Louis and Houston, and he ran into a wall, Justin Smith. It's a one-yard gain.
And you talked about Hardesty's carries. He only got 95 yards, but they did convert a great deal of their third downs because he just kept pecking away. That offensive line did a good job against Seattle, but this challenge today against the 49ers, they are definitely stepping up in class.
And they're missing a guy who ran for nearly 1,200 yards last season, 10 touchdowns. One of the great stories in the NFL last year, a workhorse for this Cleveland team. On second and nine, look at the time for McCoy underneath, and Obanaya takes a shot by Navarro Bowman. Good smack there. It's a five-yard pickup.
Obanaya was the Browns' leading receiver last week against Seattle with five catches, and he's very familiar with Colt McCoy. Obviously, they played 4 years together at the University of Texas, and that really helps out with the communication for both Obanaya and Colt McCoy.
Obanaya, former seventh-round draft pick back in 2009. Aldon Smith, tremendous young pass rusher, has checked in for San Francisco. Third and four now for the Browns. McCoy from the gun. McCoy slant, bobbled, almost intercepted. It was Chris Culliver, the rookie out of South Carolina, that had his hands on it. And the Browns are forced to punt.
Well, Culliver did a good job, but Greg Little kind of quit on this route. Culliver got inside, pushed him a little bit, and with the size and strength of Greg Little, he's got to power through that defensive back and make that catch. But he's inexperienced as a wide receiver, his first year with the Browns playing that position.
Cleveland playing without Mohamed Massaquah, who's out with a concussion, their best wide receiver. Brad Maynard punting. Ted Ginn, return man. Ginn lets it bounce, and Cleveland will have a chance to down it. They do. Inside the one, T.J. Ward getting downfield. San Francisco with a 7-0 lead over Clinton. Signature 49ers calls.
Back to pass is Brody. He throws into the end zone to McElhinney, complete the touchdown. John Brody just threw the most important touchdown, perhaps, of what will be a great pro career.
I don't know if you recognize the last name, but of course Bob is our partner here, Dan Fouts' dad, and he's watching this game right now, taking down notes, I'm sure.
He would have loved that first play for the 49ers on defense. That red dog got to the quarterback.
That's Bob was the voice of the 49ers amongst other teams here in the San Francisco area, Bay Area Radio Hall of Famer.
False start, number 49 offense. Half the distance to the goal, still first down.
And that's Bruce Miller. He's the rookie out of Central Florida, stepping in for Moran Norris, who continues to sit. Norris out with a fibula injury, and Miller, a former defensive end in college, has been converted to the fullback spot.
Yeah, that moved the ball to the 8-inch line from the 16-inch line. Not a bad penalty for Miller.
So first down for the 49ers, leading 7-0. And a handoff up the middle. Not much there for Frank Gore, running into a crowd, some pushing and shoving after the play. San Francisco has played six games, and yet they lead the division by three games over the Seattle Seahawks. Last time they've had a five-game winning streak, you have to go back to 2001, and what a job Jim Harbaugh has done. We asked him about taking over, what's been the biggest surprise. He said, the perception about pro football players is they're prima donnas. I have found that to be completely erroneous, is what he told us on Friday. He's got great character guys, an extraordinary locker room. And it's Gore taking it to the outside. Frank Gore able to hit the perimeter and turn it upfield for a 23-yard rip.
Really a couple of key blocks on this play for any big run like this. Watch Delanie Walker here as Gore comes and uses his speed to get to the outside. But Walker, such a versatile player, takes out two Browns. And then Gore never wants to go out of bounds. He's always looking for extra yards. After contact there, he got six big ones.
Hard-nosed Frank Gore, two-time Pro Bowler. Over 1,000 yards for four straight years. Kendall Hunter will get an opportunity. And Hunter able to sidestep some defenders and stay on his feet. The rookie out of Oklahoma State zigzagging his way for a 25-yard gain.
Yeah, if Gore is your ground and pound, Hunter's your slash and dash. Great job of just continuing to fight over the left side here. He'll cut back. It's a little misdirection and missed tackles by the Browns. Ward misses and a couple more miss. Adams misses in the secondary. And Hayden has to come all the way over from his cornerback on the other side of the field. How about two plays from their goal line, now out to midfield for the Niners.
Some questions about Kendall Hunter's size at 5'7", 199. He has answered those in the first part of his rookie year. But a bootleg, and Smith able to hit Joe Staley. San Francisco mixing it up and Staley getting involved. The starting offensive tackle, good for 17 yards on the catch and run.
Well, here's Staley on the end of the line of scrimmage. The receiver on the outside is off the line of scrimmage, so that makes Staley eligible. And, you know, the great thing about that is Alex Smith gave him a ball he could not miss. Threw it right between the 7 and the 4, and you bet, first down 49ers for Joe Staley.
Alex Boone was in as an extra lineman, so that puts Staley in a position to contribute. First and 10, San Francisco on the move just short of the 30-yard line, and a jump from the Cleveland side.
False start, number 75, offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
And that was Boone, called on the false start. Let's go to New York, NFL Today update. JB and Shannon Sharp.
Hey, Shannon, this is the way to start things off if you're Pittsburgh.
Coach said they need to start fast and not settle for field goals, and they've done just that. 5-yard touchdown catch. Melody Moore, Pittsburgh's on top, 7-0, and driving again.
Obviously a big one there in Pittsburgh. Back to Ian and Dan.
And no doubt, guys, Steelers have found their footing now. 3 consecutive wins, big test today against the New England Patriots. First and 15 for the San Francisco 49ers. Staley with his first NFL catch. Fifth-year first-round pick out of 2007. Smith. Pats the ball, throws, and connects with Braylon Edwards. Inside the 30, good diving grab by Edwards as we check back in for another NFL Today update.
Hey, Shannon, Dan Fouts may be able to answer this, but how do you get that wide open?
I don't know. I've played a long time in this league, Dan, and I've never been this wide open. Matthew Stafford, 41 yards. Titus Young, 7-3. Lions over the Broncos.
Back to the bird and the beard.
What do you think?
Well, JB, it's about practice. You got to practice those things, Shannon.
We're talking about practice. Hand off to Gore. And Frank Gore, good cut up the middle for 5 yards. Jamie Mitchell there defensively for Cleveland. Let's take a look at this defense for the Browns. Ataba Rubin has played at a Pro Bowl level and has been a leader for the young guys, Taylor and Sheard. Scott Fujita back after the concussion. Fujita did not suit up last week in the win over Seattle. And in the secondary, T.J. Ward, a San Francisco native. 100 friends and family in attendance, and he paid for the tickets. So they're rooting for him, not the 49ers.
You bet they are.
Third and 2. Play fake. Smith under some pressure. Now he's got some room. Smith. And diving forward should be enough for the first down. Joe Hayden with the tackle. Jabal Sheard provided the heat, and then Smith was able to loop out of trouble for the first down.
And I think he surprised Joe Hayden with this move at the end. Watch Hayden right up here. As Smith comes out, he knows what he needs for the first down. Hayden's thinking, oh, he's going to slide here. He's going to run out of bounds. He cuts back inside. Great effort to pick up the first down by Alex Smith.
But boy, this is a Browns team that only allowed 137 yards last week to Seattle. San Francisco having its way on this drive. And Gore, 1 yard gain up the gut. Brian Schaefering with the stop.
Well, both these teams offensively, before we got an injured 49er on the field, that appears to be Mike Upati, that outstanding left guard you were talking about earlier, Ian.
Yes, is sponsored by the Home Depot. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. And by Verizon, the official wireless service provider of the NFL.
Injury here, Mike Iapati able to walk off. So Adam Snyder moves from right guard to left guard. And Shiloh Rachel is in, the fourth-year offensive lineman from USC. Smith in the pocket. Gets rid of it over the middle to Vernon Davis. And Davis able to roll towards the 10 for an 8-yard gain.
Let's go back and check out the injury to Iapati. He's going to be pulling here, and he's going to run into Snyder. And then coming down from his defensive end spot, Jabal Sheard drills him on the hip. And he's back in the lineup. Good news for the 49ers. And I know that for Adam Snyder, he's happy to go back to his right tackle spot because he was blocking on Ataba Rubin. And that's not the guy you want to be blocking against.
Some additional beef. Sopoaga is in. On a give for Dorr. And he is cut down. Behind the line of scrimmage, no gain on the play. Chris Gokong, first man there.
Gokong and Mike Adams on the safety blitz, the run blitz for Dick Duron's defense. A big play on third down. Now decision time for Harbaugh, and he's going to send out David Akers.
This is the number four team defense in the NFL, allowing 291 yards per game. The top four teams all out of the AFC North. David Akers on for a 29-yard field goal attempt. Andy Lee will hold it. What a pickup Akers has turned out to be. Five-time Pro Bowler, parted ways with Philadelphia. From 29 yards away, Akers knocks it through. It's 10-0 San Francisco.
You're watching the NFL on CBS.
49ers with a 10-0 advantage on the Cleveland Browns Halloween weekend here in San Francisco. 11 plays, 88 yards. Remember, they started that drive at the half-yard line. San Francisco getting it done on the ground with Gore and Kendall Hunter. And eventually kicking the 29-yard field goal with David Akers. Akers kicks it off. Joshua Cribbs waiting. 1 yard deep, he'll take it out. And Cribbs running into his own man initially, slowing down, and then C.J. Spillman bringing him down across the 20-yard line. That's where Cleveland will open up. Halloween night, the star of A Nightmare on Elm Street comes to Hawaii 5-0. That's tomorrow, only CBS.
Yeah, kind of like your junior sportscaster costume you're wearing today.
This one?
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, I've kind of nailed this one. Maybe I should put the blazer back on. That really does the trick.
Week after week, the same costume.
Some people did not dress up for Halloween. It was just a regular Sunday for some of us. Cleveland, 3 points in first quarters this season. Handoff. Obanaya keeps the legs churning and is brought down to the 24 by Bowman. It's a 4-yard pickup.
Well, it's doubtful that Hardesty will get 33 carries again against the 49ers as he got against the Seahawks. Obanaya will see a lot of action today to keep both of them fresh. With Hillis out, there are only three running backs. Owen Marisick is the fullback, but he rarely plays tailback, if at all.
Pat Shermer, who spent a year out in this area of the country as an assistant coach at Stanford in 1998 under Tyrone Willingham. Second and six, McCoy fires, and wide open. He's able to make the connection. Jordan Norwood. Out of Penn State, 14-yard gain and third catch of the season for Norwood.
Yeah, and it's just a simple hook route by Norwood. Covered on the outside by Terrell Brown. And you can see the good sharp route and good timing on that play. That's the key to this offense, is precision, routes, and timing with the quarterback.
San Francisco is down a corner. Tremaine Brock is out with a broken left hand. McCoy fires, high throw, and it flutters over the head of Norwood. Incomplete. Get scores and manage CBS Sports Fantasy Football teams on your mobile phone. To get the free app, simply call *CBS or go to cbssports.com/mobile.
And Brown fans have seen just too much of that from Colt McCoy this season. Balls that flutter come out of his hand and overthrow his wide open receivers.
Second and 10. Handoff. Obanaya. And he takes it to the 41-yard line for a 2-yard pickup. Patrick Willis coming over to make the stop for San Francisco. And right now, why don't we check out our Falcons focus on one of the best defensive players in the league.
Well, this is why he's one of the best. The pre-snap read gives him an idea where the ball is going. Then his reactions combined with blazing speed allow him to get to the perimeter. And as all great linebackers, Willis finishes the play. He joins Hall of Famer Ronnie Lott as the only Niners to earn Pro Bowl honors in their first 4 years.
You think that X-ray vision helps as well?
It always helps. It's got to help.
Third and seven. McCoy with a deep drop. McCoy gets rid of it. And incomplete. He was trying to hit Greg Little on a crossing route. And it came off his fingertips. Pressure was coming. And the Browns will punt once again.
Yeah, 49ers doing a good job of making Colt McCoy uncomfortable in the pocket. That time it looked like Little had some room. If he could have gotten that ball in his hands with his size and strength, might have been able to pick up the first down.
So Brad Maynard, the former Giant and Chicago Bear, one of the highest drafted punters ever, third round pick back in 1997. Punting to the dangerous Ted Ginn, who does have a 55-yard return for a touchdown this season. Rolls out of bounds right around the 17-yard line. 49ers with a 10-0 lead here in San Francisco, hometown of Dan Fouts, and this is your life.
Oh, no.
Yes, St. Ignatius High School. We had our staff get the Zapruder film, and then they were able to dig up this.
Digging up is right.
Look at the gun on that young man.
Well, that's Larry Burt going in from 65 yards out, Ian. That was against Bellarmine, and SI that year, 1967, won the West Catholic Athletic League Championship, and I want to thank you for showing that again.
That's right. Dan Fouts. Oh, he had the look even then. He just did not have the facial hair. People have always asked me, did Dan always have the beard?
Obviously not.
No. Bootleg. Smith connects with Michael Crabtree, and he gets brought down low by Usama Young. Well, St. Ignatius High School here in California, Jerry Brown, governor of California, Gordon Getty, oil tycoon and billionaire, Igor Olshansky. I think Igor was a freshman when you were a senior.
I don't think so. I think he just born yesterday. You know, about Igor, he went also went to the University of Oregon and was drafted by the San Diego Chargers. So
he just followed your whole path.
He's my idol.
And he likes to wear a beard on occasion. 10-0, San Francisco leads it at the end of the aerial coverage of today's action being provided by the fine folks at MetLife. One word, Dan, spectacular. Don't you think?
Yeah, my heart's somewhere there.
Where is it?
I left it there somewhere.
Yeah, we'll get it after the game. Second and six for the 49ers. Upati is back on that left side for San Francisco on a pitch now for Gore. And Cleveland all over it. Jamie Mitchell and DaQuell Jackson there to make the stop on Gore. Well, it was the handshake heard around the world after San Francisco's 25-19 win over Detroit. Jim Harbaugh and Jim Schwartz. And oh, it's not over. Harbaugh running away. Jim Schwartz has some things to say. Afterwards, Jim Harbaugh said, yeah, I might have gone in a little too hard on the handshake.
Yeah, not exactly your protocol, as Jim Schwartz would prefer.
But Jim Harbaugh still has not apologized. Didn't feel as if he did anything wrong.
It was just a handshake.
Smith in stride to Vernon Davis. What a weapon he is. Davis out across the 35-yard line and a first down for the 49ers. It covers 19 yards.
Yeah, important to get Vernon Davis going early in this ball game. It opens up so many things. The deep crossing route for Davis as he comes in behind two receivers. You can see the clear out there by Crabtree, and there's just no Brown in the area for Davis as he crosses the 35.
Now Davis comes to the sideline. He's flexing his right hand. Here's Gore. Oh, look at Gore go! Frank Gore getting to the second level and turning it up a notch for 26 yards. Good block by Bruce Miller to help spring Gore loose.
Yeah, Miller's doing a great job from that fullback spot, getting out in front. Look, as he reads the block of Snyder, gets inside and takes out Joe Hayden. How about this effort by Rubin, though? Getting down the field, looks like Gore was going to try to cut back inside and inside of Usama Young, but the great hustle by number 71 right there, Rubin, with the big play.
Good mixture so far from Jim Harbaugh and offensive coordinator Greg Roman for San Francisco. Kendall Hunter now in the backfield for the 49ers. Smith to throw. Plenty of time. Smith, and releasing over the middle. He hits Justin Peel, third string tight end, for a first down, 19-yard hookup.
When you run the ball as effectively as the 49ers have, the passing game becomes so easy. The time to throw for Alex Smith to find Peel over the middle. Another crossing route. Here's the tight end. And again, nobody near Smith, nobody near Peel. 49ers have three runs now of 24 yards or more. Smith hot, 6 of 7 for 74.
49ers carving up this Cleveland defense here in the first half. It's 10-0 San Francisco. Gore sent to the outside. Shotgun for Smith in the red zone. Smith pumps. Smith releases over the middle to Crabtree. And Michael Crabtree inside the 10. Covers 10 yards. And a new set of downs for the 49ers. DeQuell Jackson on the stop for Cleveland.
And you know, Ian, as uncomfortable as Colt McCoy looks, how comfortable does Alex Smith look? And how effective has he been distributing the ball to his receivers? He's getting time to throw because of the great running attack, but even on that play, it looked like in the past he might have taken that ball and taken off running.
Sopoaga is in. Alex Boone is in. 7 straight completions for Smith. This is a first and goal now for the 49ers. On again. Gore steamrolling. Frank Gore is in. Touchdown, 49ers.
Now, there's no secret that the 49ers want to run behind Iupati. Watch him pull, and he'll just clear out this entire Brown defense. Lead block there by the fullback, but watch 77 come in there. There's nobody even for him to block. Gore gets real close to him, that 330 pounds, overpowering the Browns, and Gore's got another 6, or does he? They're going to review this upstairs as they review every touchdown.
That extra effort from Gore, he wouldn't go down on contact from Taylor.
After reviewing the play, the runner's left elbow was down with the ball short of the goal line. The ball will be placed at the half-yard line, second down, and we'll wind the clock on the ready.
So take the points off the board. 49ers will have it at the half-yard line as Gore was ruled down before he got the touchdown.
Yeah, the elbow hits just an instant before the ball crosses the plane. Great camera work there to show the left elbow hitting the ground right there. Now, where's the ball? It's just about an inch short. Although they're going to say it's about 8 inches short.
Second and goal for the 49ers. Sopoaga in the backfield. And Gore is hit. The white jerseys converge in on Gore, and the Browns were ready. Gokong among those there. It's a loss of 1.
That's 2 big plays for Gokong. Watch number 51 just dive right in here. Sopoaga misses his block, and that's why you sometimes like the beef that Sopoaga can give you. He weighs 330 pounds, but does he know which guy to block that time? He totally whiffed on the big linebacker, went after a smaller secondary man.
San Francisco with a 10-0 lead, trying to add to it here with a third and goal. Give is to Gore, and Gore is stopped short of the goal line. Philip Taylor, talented rookie out of Baylor, the number 21 pick overall, in on that stop for Cleveland. And now what if you're San Francisco?
Well, you know these fans want them to go for it. Harbaugh is done to stay in there, and he's going to let them have it if they don't get in here. Last two plays, the Browns have got good penetration on the Niners.
Fourth down, Smith to Gore. Frank Gore sticks the helmet down. Is he in?
No.
Gore is short, and the Browns have held up on the goal line for defensive coordinator Dick Chiron. DeQuell Jackson sliding through. Another look now. Was Frank Gore in? On the field, it was ruled short of a touchdown for Gore. Dan, what did you see?
Well, I see his knee hit and the ball hit at the same time, and his ball will land right on the goal line. I think that's a touchdown.
San Francisco has challenged.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. San Francisco will be charged their first time out.
Now the 49ers do not win the challenge. Bill Levy may be deciding that there just was not enough evidence to overturn it. San Francisco has one timeout remaining, and that was a huge call as the Browns take over.
Yeah, good use of the booth review on the first play that showed that Gore was down, but I still think that the knee hits simultaneously with the ball, and when the ball hits, it's on the goal line. That is a touchdown. But from that angle, tough to see, and I'm sure that's what Bill Levy was looking at. Not enough evidence to overturn the call on the field. Bigger problems for the Browns, though. Quarterback's feet getting the snap with his feet in the end zone.
On first down for Cleveland. Marisic, the rookie out of Stanford, able to give Cleveland a little bit of breathing room there for a yard and a half up the middle. So Jim Harbaugh electing to go for it. Still felt that Gore did enough to get there, but doesn't get the points on the board.
Yeah, and he still has his defense out on the field, and the Browns with 99 yards to go to get to the end zone on the other end of the field. So he loves his defense, no question.
Obanaya in the backfield. McCoy lost the football. On the exchange, Marisic, it looked like, was going forward to block it, and McCoy was trying to turn to hand the ball off to Obanaya. Cleveland recovers it.
Yeah, it's a good call, Ian, because as McCoy comes out, he's going to bump in to Marisic right there. That causes the ball to come out, but how about heads up on McCoy's part to beat the Niners for the recovery?
Colt McCoy is 2 of 5 for 18 yards. And he does have a fumble back in the first quarter that San Francisco eventually turned into 7 points. Third and long. Watson, the motion man. Moving pocket for McCoy. He throws, and it's complete. Benjamin Watson, the veteran tight end. That covers 16 yards and a first down for the Browns.
Yeah, a great play call by Pat Shurmur, too. Get McCoy out here. Tight end Watson comes on a down and out after coming in motion here. But get away from that pressure. McCoy throws very well on the run. Look at this strike right in the lane. Perfect for Watson.
And we'll talk about this West Coast offense and McCoy trying to adjust to it. On a handoff, Obanaya, and Paris Harrelson shoots through to bring him down. It's a gain of 1. Follow the NFL while on the go. The NFL's mobile apps are all new for the 2011 season. To get the apps, go to NFL.com/mobile. How about the West Coast offense? What goes into running the West Coast offense for a young quarterback?
Well, there's a lot of practice that goes into it, a lot of timing, working with your receivers, syncing up your drops, your steps with the receiver's routes. Very complicated, and yet this doesn't help at all. Jumping off sides is Pechos.
False start, number 79 offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
So it is the former 49er, Tony Pechos, called on the penalty.
And that's really been a tough thing for Colt McCoy, because he comes out of the University of Texas as basically a shotgun quarterback. And a lot of quarterbacks these days come out of college, come out of high school. They're all running the spread. They're all running the pistol. They're all running the shotgun. And for Colt, he's got to learn how to time up his drops with the depth of his receivers' routes. And that's been an ongoing process for the Browns.
Yeah, what did Pat Shurmur tell us? Most quarterbacks from the eighth grade on, that's all they know, working out of the gun. On the pitch, Obanaya, and the football jarred loose. Joe Thomas going back there to get it. Obanaya had the ball knocked right out of his hands.
The 49ers have forced 14 fumbles this year. They recovered one earlier in this ball game. Looked like Obanaya had something going here. But a tackle right on the ball looked like Dante Wintner with the hit right on the ball. And there's nothing Obanaya can do but hope that somebody like Joe Thomas is there for the recovery.
We've seen more Obanaya than we've seen Hardesty. Hardesty, 2 carries, 6 yards. Obanaya, 5 carries for 11 yards. Third and long. McCoy with a deep drop. Flushed out of the pocket. Flag is down. And McCoy throwing on the move. Incomplete. Came off the hands of Greg Little, the rookie out of North Carolina, as Ray McDonald
personal
was
foul, face
rushing.
Mask, number 62 of the offense. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Jason Pinkston called on the face mask. It doesn't matter. Incomplete.
Yeah, Pinkston was grabbing the face mask of Alden Smith, who had a real nice pass rush on this. He came to the inside, and Pinkston, here is Alden Smith. He comes to the inside here, and the guard is Pinkston. Watch his right hand come out here, and that pulls on the face mask. Bill Levy with the flag, and we've got another 49er down.
Now this time it's Ray McDonald who was banged up.
Mark Harmon.
Ray McDonald came off to the sideline, injured on the previous play. Brad Maynard punting. High bounce. Ted Ginn waits for it and brought down to the 35-yard line. So nothing there as Buster Screen got down the field. It has been all San Francisco in this first half. 49ers with a 10-0 lead on the Browns. San Francisco Bay, there's the Bay Bridge linking the city of San Francisco to Oakland. We were actually in Oakland last week, had fantastic weather, and it might actually be nicer today here in the Bay Area.
Well, no wind at Candlestick. Stop the presses.
5:52 to go in this first half. San Francisco with a 10-0 lead on Cleveland. Kendall Hunter in the game. Alex Boone in as well. Fake the handoff. Smith steps. Dials up the deep ball. Incomplete. He was trying to hit Crabtree, who's coming back from a left foot injury. Incomplete.
Great defense by the Browns. Last time the Niners had the ball on the one-inch line. Rookie Phil Taylor with the stop there. Here comes Gopong on the blitz. Then another linebacker, Kaluka Maiava, with the stop here. And then finally, it's DeQuell Jackson, who keeps Gore out of the end zone. Tremendous goal line stand by the Browns.
Second and 10. Ball just across the 35-yard line. Davis and Walker, the tight ends. On the delay for Gore. And Gore knifing through and then dishing out some punishment as he takes it to midfield. 14-yard gain. Jonathan Goodwin starting center, helping to create a little bit of extra room for Gore.
Yeah, a little draw play here. Gore gets to the second level, and that second level is TJ Ward right there, and he knocks Ward right on his wallet. Frank Gore combines tremendous power with the low center of gravity, and he gets to the second level, those secondary men, and oftentimes he makes the miss or he punishes them.
Now, we asked Ward about Gore. He said he seems to squeeze through areas that don't even look like they're holes, but Gore is able to make something out of it. It's Gore again. The stop and go by Gore, it's so effective where he waits and uses his vision and that acceleration for a 5-yard pickup. Ataba Rubin couldn't bring him down initially, and then Gokong comes over to make the play.
And really, that's the number one characteristic of a classic eye back, tailback, that vision, but also the patience to let the blocking develop in front of him, and then the explosion to get through that little crack, as you talked about.
Yeah, he is on a roll, and he's inching closer to Roger Craig for second on the 49ers all-time rushing list. Came in 110 yards away. He's got 94 here in the first half. Second and 5. Smith pitched the handoff on the slant for Braylon Edwards, former first-round draft pick of the Cleveland Browns back in 2005, number 3 pick overall. 9-yard gain. Let's go to New York. JB and Shannon.
Denver getting, make that Detroit getting some help from an ex-Denver player.
Yes, Tony Scheffler used to be the tight end for the Denver Broncos. Now he's making 28-yard grabs against the Denver Broncos. 3 plays later, he catches a touchdown. The Lions are out early, JB, 17-3.
bat they are. Let's take it back to Ian and Dan.
And NFL Today, earlier today, we knew that was rough for Shannon to make that Detroit selection against his old team, the Denver Broncos, but Shannon picks with his brain, not his heart. Kendall Hunter. And Hunter stays on his feet. Finally brought down after he picked up four on the sprint towards the sideline. Gokong and Fujita collaborating to bring him down. Coming up, sprint halftime report. JB and the rest of the crew, latest NFL scores and highlights. Some surprises in week eight. It's all coming up on the sprint halftime report. Usama Young injured on that play. So the Browns medical staff comes out to take a look at the fifth-year pro from Kent State. And Young gets up on his own power. So two players from Kent State on the Browns roster with Josh Cribbs, who played quarterback there. Cribbs played high school football with Vernon Davis of the 49ers. How about that team at Dunbar in D.C.?
And he said that Vernon Davis in high school was the same size he is now.
Yeah, I kind of knew back then that Vernon would probably make the NFL. And he ran a 4.3, by the way. They both participated on the track team at Dunbar.
Yeah, that works.
Let's break out his high school footage while we're at it.
Probably better than what we've shown.
Second and six. Smith going up top for Crabtree. And Chris Gokong, the linebacker, sticking with him step for step.
Now this is the matchup you want if you're the 49ers. A wide receiver in Crabtree on a wheel route there. And Gokong, the good thing that Gokong did there is the angle he took. He knows he can't run with Crabtree, but if you take the best angle possible, then it cuts down on the chances for the completion. That was great job by Gokong.
Chris Gokong, Santa Barbara, California native out of Cal Poly. San Luis Obispo, third and six. Smith, quick hitter to Edwards. Alex Smith knew exactly what he was going to do with a football. 13-yard gain. And boy, Smith looks like a confident player under this Jim Harbaugh run offense.
And to have this big body, Braylon Edwards at 6'3", 215. Joe Hayden playing off into the outside, just opened up that slant route. That's easy pickings for Harbaugh's Smith and Edwards.
Yeah, we asked Alex about Edwards. He said he's such a unique player. I've never played with anybody like him. Such a weapon one-on-one. His body control is amazing. Hand off to Gore. And Jabal Sheard. Good play by Sheard. We told you about the rookie from Baylor, Philip Taylor. Sheard's another good one in his first year from Pittsburgh. 3-yard gain as we hit the 2-minute warning here in the second quarter. Cleveland fortunate they're down only 10-0. But coming up, sprint halftime report. JB and company, scores, highlights around the NFL. That's all coming up on the sprint halftime report. Ian Eagle, Dan Fouts, our producer Bob Monsbach, director Suzanne Smith, the rest of our crew. Here at Candlestick, 2nd and 7 for the 49ers. They lead 10-0. 2 minutes to play in this first half. Crabtree goes in motion. Smith on a give for Gore, slithers and picks up 6. Sets up 3rd and short now for the 49ers.
And a lot of options for Alex Smith. That time the Browns were coming on a blitz, they had the 49ers had the perfect play called, the draw play to Frank Gore.
Browns use a timeout. Gore now 103 yards rushing first half.
What's this all about?
We're giving Rich the NFL experience of a goal line dive.
Really?
There's an easier way to get an ultimate NFL fan experience. Just snap the tag wherever Bud Light is sold and you could win. Bud Light in the NFL. Here we go.
Can I make it?
On the internet, yes. Into the end zone, no.
Jim Harbaugh telling us Alex Smith has been very easy to coach, mentally, physically tough. And really the key for Harbaugh when he took over the team, he had to figure out if Alex wanted to be a backup quarterback and wear his hat backwards, or if he wanted to go out and compete and wear his hat the right way.
Yeah, Harbaugh's not a hat backwards guy or a flat brim hat guy. No. He's got a good curve there on that hat.
Yeah.
He wants his quarterbacks to wear a hat like that.
Curve brim.
After the Cleveland timeout, 149 left to play in this first half. Smith running. First down and more down the sideline and veers out of bounds inside the five. Empty backfield, and it's Smith maybe going back to his high school days at Helix High School.
Well, watch the 49ers come in and just seal off this side. This is a run all the way. This play would have made Red Hickey happy. This is a shotgun running play. In fact, he looks a lot like Bobby Waters, the old 49er head coach who put in the shotgun for the 49ers back when they had Billy Kilmer on first down, Bobby Waters on second down, and Brody would come in and clean up the mess on third.
The Red Hickey reference was for your dad, admit it.
And all the 49er fans watching, are you kidding?
First and goal for San Francisco. It's Gore. And driven backwards. Ataba Rubin. Boy, Rubin has really developed in his fourth year out of Iowa State. Used to back up Sean Rogers and has become one of the premier run stuffers in the NFL.
And do you think the 49ers might have a play-action pass down here on this part of the field? They keep banging their heads against this Cleveland Browns stone wall on the goal line.
Former head coach of the Bears and the Buffalo Bills, Dick Turan, now running the defense for Cleveland.
That time Sopawago gets the right guy to block, but there are just too many Browns. That penetration down low, really the key on that play. Scott Fujita. Good linebacker play by Fujita, Jackson, and Gokong we're seeing here in the second quarter for Cleveland.
San Francisco has ran twice as many plays as the Cleveland Browns in this first half. This will be play number 36 on offense for the 49ers. The Browns have 18. You see what Frank Gore has done. He is now 7 yards away from moving into second place in franchise history in rushing yards. The 49ers have now outscored their opponents 177-97 this season. And the rushing yards have been impressive. Highest three-game total over the last three games since 2006, 580 yards on the ground. Second and goal. Kendall Hunter is in. Smith throws for the touchdown. Crabtree on the catch. And the 49ers add to their lead, late stages of the second quarter.
Perfect play call on the goal line. Usama Young was coming on the blitz. Here's Young coming on the blitz, and right out of the backfield comes Crabtree after the fake to Miller. Wide open, easy score for the 49ers.
12 plays, 64 yards. And Pat Shurmur's team is getting shut out. 49ers an extra point away from a 17-0 lead. Extra point from Akers. 1:31 to play, first half.
First touchdown catch of the year for Michael Crabtree as he's over that left foot injury. Told us he's close to 100%. This will help heal any injury. An easy touchdown. And how about Alex Smith? Is he on fire in this first half? 10 of 13. He's over 100 yards passing for the Niners.
Smith said he's just having a lot of fun. This staff is all about football. They're very demanding. They coach hard. And he is a hat facing the right way kind of guy, is he not?
He's got it on forward, I know that. And a big smile and bit of growth there on that chin.
Yeah, what's going on there?
It seems to be very popular now in pro sports. You're seeing all these baseball players, hockey players in the Stanley Cup, all trying to grow that beard.
Well, what do you say? That you started a trend?
Well, I was right after Abe Lincoln.
Yeah, it goes Lincoln, Fouts, everybody else. Iron Eagle, Dan Fouts, the bird and the beard.
We have a bird's eye view, don't we?
We sure do. We are up high, but it is quite a sight here at Candlestick.
I think we could have got a ticket to the game. We had to do the game in the blimp.
That's pretty much our view for those at home that are wondering. Akers will kick it off, and Josh Cribbs is deep. And the Browns desperately need something to give them a jolt.
How about a kickoff return?
They have 58 total yards of offense. Cribbs. Contact out across the 15 and brought down at the 17. Blake Costanzo making the play, the former Cleveland Brown. And Saturday, it is the college football game of the year. Top-ranked Tigers of LSU take on the second-ranked Alabama Crimson Tide. It's Saturday in primetime right here on CBS Sports. 1-2 in the land, LSU and Alabama. Any predictions from you, Dan?
Well,
cool,
LSU.
Cool. Line.
My duck, so I got to go with LSU.
So scientific. McCoy throwing to the outside. Obanaya with the grab. Calf injury for Hardesty. His return is up in the air. So it has been mostly Chris Obanaya. Hardesty had stepped in for Peyton Hillis. Hillis inactive once again with a hamstring injury. Missed a game earlier this season with strep throat against Miami. He's really had a lot of drama, contract issues as well. 7-3. McCoy. And a stamp.
Yeah, it's going to draw a flag, too. Going right to the head.
Deshaun Goldson.
Yeah. Greg Little trying to catch this ball with Goldson coming right at his grill. That will draw the flag every time. It's our line judge, Mark Perlman, with the flag.
Personal foul. Number 38 defense. Blow to the head. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
And now what you're thinking, if you're a Brown fan, can the Browns get Phil Dawson in range? Remember last week, he accounted for all their scoring with a pair of 50-yard plus field goals against Seattle.
Dawson also had two field goals blocked from 48 yards and 24 yards away.
And those are his only two misses all year.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't put that on the field goal kicker.
Dealing with a right thigh bruise. Over 1,100 career points for the Browns, second only to Lou Groza in franchise history. First down, McCoy underneath the curl by Little. And Greg Little, some talking after the play. Browns have to hurry here. A minute four to go.
Yeah, Ahmad Brooks lost his helmet again. He's going to have to tighten the screws on that chin strap.
Brooks used to go against the Browns when he was in the division as a member of the Bengals. McCoy. And loops one out of bounds. Navarro Bowman providing the pressure on Colt McCoy.
That was some blitz by Navarro Bowman. He looked like a running back, dodging blockers, spinning in the hole, and almost getting to McCoy. Here he comes. Watch him spin right in here and get after McCoy. Heck of a move by Bowman. An equally great move by McCoy.
Bowman, who backed up to Keo Spikes last year, was the leading tackler on special teams. Now he's the leading tackler overall for this defense. And he and Patrick Willis have been a 1-2 punch at the linebacker spot. McCoy gets rid of it. It's complete at midfield. Jordan Norwood. And a 4-yard gain. Cleveland has the one timeout remaining. Clock is ticking. 33-32 left in this first half. And they trail 17-0.
They need about 15 yards to get Dawson about a 54-yarder.
As long this year as 53. McCoy looking. Knocked up in the air and almost caught by Cribbs. It's incomplete.
A little bit too much dink and dunk, though, in this passing attack for the Browns. They just don't stretch the field with any of their receivers or their pass routes. They don't have enough time. They don't have enough timeouts. Cribbs should have made that catch after the deflection. Might have surprised him here, but it went right through his hands, right to the ground.
Greg Little was the intended receiver. No Massaqua out with a concussion. Watson was questionable. He is playing after suffering a concussion. And timeout called by San Francisco. Play clock was winding down for Cleveland. Halloween Monday, Ashton Kutcher and John Cryer star in a disturbingly funny new Two and a Half Men. That's tomorrow only. CBS.
At some point, you got to see the Browns stretch the field, use some speed. Maybe Carlton Mitchell, the second-year guy out of South Florida, who's ready to play after suffering a broken left ring finger. He's got some speed, but we haven't seen him yet. But all these short passes just don't have enough time or timeouts to get down the field with them.
Phil Dawson's career-long field goal is 56 yards. They would need 11 more yards to get to that point for Dawson. This is a Cleveland squad that's averaging 16.2 points per game. That's fifth worst in the NFL. Three wins this season have come over Indianapolis, Miami, and Seattle.
I'm coming with you, Joe. I got you.
16 seconds left. McCoy faked the handoff, sets and throws on a sideline route, connects with Jordan Norwood. Norwood turned, the ball was there.
Yeah, that's great timing by McCoy. I think Norwood may have caught that ball in self-defense.
They're now at the 45-yard line, and they've got 8 seconds to work with here.
But they do have one timeout. So they can use the entire field. They don't have to throw the ball to the sidelines. They just have to do things quickly.
Well, USC had 8 seconds to work with last night against Stanford. They ran out of time in regulation. McCoy floats one. And he dropped it right in the bucket to Josh Cribbs. And out of bounds at the 33-yard line. That covers 11 yards, 4 seconds left, and they'll send Dawson out onto the field.
Well, 49ers are claiming he juggled this ball, but he had full control of the ball as he hits the ground. That's a heck of a catch, and just a beautiful throw by Colt McCoy. Getting it over the defender, Whitner, and right to Cribbs for the big play.
Phil Dawson, 51-yard field goal attempt to get Cleveland on the board. Maynard will hold it. From 51 yards away, Dawson. And he drills it to end this first half. Browns get some points before we hit the break. ...51-yard field goal for Phil Dawson. He had plenty of distance. Shermer likes it. They're trying to build some momentum as we hit halftime. Sprint Halftime Report is coming up after this word from your local station. You're watching the NFL.
Hey, we back at home.
Getting ready for second half action here in San Francisco. 49ers 17, the Browns 3. Right now, let's take a look at the NFL mobile recap presented by Verizon.
Yeah, second play of the game from scrimmage for the Browns. Ahmad Brooks with the sack and strip fumble of Colt McCoy. Isaac Sopawaga with the recovery. Great start for the 49ers, and it's from the Browns standpoint, from that point on, it's been almost all downhill until that long field goal by Phil Dawson.
Ian Eagle along with Dan Fouts, Halloween weekend here in San Francisco, and this 49ers team has really taken on the personality of its head coach, Jim Harbaugh. They're having fun, they're winning, and this is a team that has adapted well to his offense. Defense has played at a high level, and the numbers are lopsided.
Well, and this is from a team that's coming off a bye week, and so far this season, coming into today's game, only four teams out of 13 coming off a bye week had been successful. So Harbaugh giving his team 6 days off in a row, and they look fresh and very effective.
And Cleveland kicks off to start this second half with Ted Ginn slipping as he comes up shy of the 10-yard line. He's brought down at the 9. Mayaba with the stop on special teams. First half possessions for San Francisco, and look at the one 10-play, 82-yard drive. They turned it over on downs, but they thought they had a touchdown on a couple of occasions on that drive.
Yeah, great goal line stand by the Browns, but that's been all for the Browns defense. The 49ers, Alex Smith just had an outstanding first half. 10 of 13 for 108 yards, one touchdown, no interception. And, of course, Frank Gore already over 100 yards in that first half.
San Francisco did not punt in that first half. So Andy Lee has only been on to hold. Smith. Moving pocket. And he throws to Braylon Edwards, but he was out of bounds. Incomplete.
Edwards had stepped out of bounds before the ball came to him. The official right on the spot threw his hat and signaled incomplete pass.
Jim Harbaugh. He says, look, we're going to keep asking questions to our team. Are we good enough? Are we competitive enough? Are we smart enough? This is how he keeps them engaged and challenged at 5-1. Haven't won a division title, had a winning record since 2002. On second down, it's Gore. And Frank Gore keeps moving forward and carries for 6 yards.
Yeah, it's been an outstanding first half for Frank Gore. This is his touchdown in the first quarter after that turnover we just showed you. This is really a key play, a 26-yarder coming off the goal line, getting in behind his blockers down the sidelines and finishing off the run.
And he has tied Garrison Hurst with his fourth consecutive 100-yard rushing game, tying Hurst's team record. And he is very close to moving up the rushing list all time in 49ers history. Third and four from the gun. They handle the rush. Smith throws. Great hands, but Crabtree could not secure it. It's ruled incomplete. Sheldon Brown had the coverage.
Got to give Sheldon Brown a good job of staying with Crabtree. Crabtree has the ball here, but look at the right hand come in there. And when they go to the ground, Crabtree cannot control the ball. He must control the ball throughout the entire process of the catch. That will bring up the first punt of the afternoon for the Niners.
And the first three and out for San Francisco as Brown just limped off. Josh Cribbs, two career touchdowns on punt returns, including one against the 49ers for 76 yards. Booming kick from Lee. Cribbs makes a cut up field and he is devoured out across the 35 by Bowman. Still making plays on special teams. 55-yard punt, 6-yard return, and a flag down.
Ineligible member of the kicking team downfield, number 51. The 5-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down, Cleveland.
So the Browns will try to climb back into this game, trailing 17-3.
Southwest.
Fly Southwest.
Right call.
Decision here was to re-kick it. So San Francisco, after the ineligible man downfield.
That was Blake Costanzo, who was downfield, a former Brown who worked with Brad Seeley. And talking to Seeley about Costanzo, and don't want to offend anybody back in New Jersey, you included. But he says that Costanzo brings that New Jersey edge to the game.
What are you saying? That I don't bring that edge?
A different type of edge.
I see.
A little softer, kinder.
Seeley was the special teams coach in Cleveland in 2009 and 2010, and he's got the special teams unit playing at a high level for San Francisco. Lee on the punt. Cribbs returnable from the 33. And Cribbs working his way through traffic across midfield, so it turns out to be the right decision for the Browns. Tavares Gooden makes the play on specials.
So the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
Frank Gore is now a yard away from sole possession of second place, most rushing yards in 49ers franchise history, currently tied with Roger Craig and behind Joe Perry, who also played in the All-America Football Conference Those yards, though, did not transfer over to the NFL yardage that Perry was able to produce as a member of the 49ers. There he is. Number 34, Joe the Jet.
Hall of Famer. One of the members of the million-dollar backfield for the 49ers. Y.A. Tittle, Hugh McElhaney, Joe the Jet Perry, and John Henry Johnson.
Had some highlights at Kezar Stadium, didn't he?
Oh.
So did you. I think we have that video. On first down, Obanaya. Good stop and go by Obanaya, who continues to get the nod here. We were told Hardesty has a calf issue, and it's been the third stringer, Chris Obanaya, who was not even on this roster a couple of weeks ago. First half possessions for the Cleveland Browns. They get that field goal just before time runs out at the end of the second quarter.
And that was a real good decision by Shermer to have the 49ers punt again. It got them 14 yards and then 7 yards on first down by Obanaya. And this is the best the Browns have looked offensively so far.
Obanaya again. Tried a little juke move and Navarro Bowman didn't bite. Give him a half yard, if that, on the play.
Real good tandem in the middle there for the Niners with Willis and Bowman. Willis was talking about Bowman and how they have a friendly competition in each game. But Bowman has really helped take a lot of the pressure and the tackles off of Patrick Willis.
They were roommates in training camp and they learned the defense together. Third and two. Little sets up in the backfield. McCoy will swing it to Little, trying to make a play, and will not. Patrick Willis sniffed it out, and it's a loss of 8.
Yeah, Willis was just too quick for Sean Laval. Laval is going to get out in front of Little. Watch Willis recognize and then pursue. Gets inside of the block by Laval, and then with a little bit of help from his pal there, makes the tackle, Dricky Jean Francois.
Brad Maynard will punt. And a flag comes down, far side.
False start, number 21 offense. 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
So the combination of Bowman and Willis making plays, and you're right about Patrick Willis getting the help from Bowman, and Willis was saying to us, hey, the more the merrier at this point. He wakes up, he's a happy guy.
He gave him a great compliment. He says, he's a spitting image of me.
Yeah, he did. It's like looking in a mirror. Ted Ginn. And fair catch called for at the 14-yard line. It's a 41-yard punt. Bowman and Willis talking shit.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. Inc., the small business card from Chase. Make your mark with Inc. And by Toyota.
Look at Kezar Stadium, the home of the 49ers from 1946. To 1970.
And they tore down the old stadium and built a really a fine high school stadium there.
Give is to Frank Gore, and Gore is demolished by Sheard. And it's a loss of 1 on the play, so he's moved back into third place on the 49ers all-time rushing list for a moment.
You know, people complain locally about this stadium, Candlestick Park. They don't remember how bad, at times, Kezar Stadium could be. A 56,000-seat stadium that only had 15,000 seats between the goal lines. Mm. And a whole lot of seagulls coming around the third quarter.
Second and 11 here for the 49ers. Still early stages, third quarter. Darts it to Davis, and the Browns will prepare. Davis is brought down to the 15-yard line. That's a 2-yard pickup. DeQuell Jackson on the stop.
And a guy that played his high school football at Kezar Stadium, none other than Mike Holmgren.
The president of the Cleveland Browns out of Lincoln High School, class of 1966, went on to USC. Who's he going up against there in that picture?
Well, that's St. Ignatius, and looks like this could be a fine here on number 89 here, going for the quarterback's knees.
$15,000 on that kid?
But that's the old days. That's a tough quarterback there, Mike Holmgren. He was all San Francisco.
He was also an assistant coach at Sacred Heart and Oak Grove before moving on. Smith. And separation, Michael Crabtree. And the ball is jarred loose.
He stepped out before he fumbled, though.
So Sheldon Brown angled over to knock it free. And Crabtree, stepping out of bounds, actually saved him on the play, 41 yards.
Yeah, Alex Smith has had Crabtree a couple times today. This time he doesn't overthrow him, but he throws it to the outside. Crabtree loses his balance and steps out of bounds, and it's a good thing for Crabtree. Is everything going the 49ers' way here? He inadvertently steps out of bounds. Brown comes from behind and punches it out right there. Ball for naught for the Browns.
Alex Smith now 12 of 17 for 150 yards. Ball spotted at the 44. And Pat Shurmur is challenging the call on the field. Well, he was out of bounds. He clearly stepped on that sideline. We'll step aside as well.
CBS.
Another look at Crabtree working that sideline. He was out of bounds. There was no challenge from Pat Shurmur, but there was a stoppage. So we're trying to determine exactly why we stepped aside and why they stopped play on the field. Frank Gore with a 2-yard gain for Gore, and that will put him into second place on the 49ers all-time rushing list, passing Roger Craig.
And he did it here in just his seventh year. And look out, Joe Perry, number 21, is coming your way next.
He came into today 390 yards away from Joe Perry. He's got 111 on the afternoon. Neither team will be charged with a timeout. They were anticipating a challenge, and it never came. Smith coughs up the football, but is right there to recover it, and Philip Taylor was able to get his hands on it. A loss of 3 on the play.
So give Philip Taylor credit for a sack on this play. And heads up by Alex Smith. See Taylor come in there with his right hand and punches it out. And Smith heads up, gets a good bounce to recover.
Joe sets up 3rd and 11 now from the 45-yard line. 8:17 and counting left in the third quarter. Gore is on the 49ers bench. Crabtree goes in motion. From the gun, Smith set up the screen for Crabtree, and the Cleveland Browns bring him down in a hurry. Jamie Mitchell initially, and then Patterson there with the help.
Well, Frank Gore limped off the field after this tackle. Let's check out his left ankle. Well, just so many big bodies in there twisting, and he just gets bent over. That is ugly. You can see Ataba Rubin there, the firm grasp on that ankle.
And on that last play, Dimitri Patterson banged up. He is now on his backside with the Browns medical staff taking a look at the 49-yard line. Looking at that left knee. Patterson, formerly with Philadelphia and Kansas City, Washington, Minnesota. He's bounced around, but he's been a good fit for this Cleveland defense.
Here he is, number 21. He's got his foot stuck in the ground as his own teammate comes over there. Jamie Mitchell.
So Andy Lee on to punt it. No punts in the first half, and now his second punt of the second half. Lee comes in averaging 50.5 yards per punt. And a net of 44.4, one of the best in the league. Josh Cripps, fair catch at the 14. Browns are down by 14 with 7:29 to go. Third quarter in San Francisco.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Universal Pictures Tower Heist, starring Ben Stiller and Eddie Murphy. Tower Heist, Friday. And by Outback Steakhouse. It's always fresh in the Outback.
Thank you. picture-perfect day here in San Francisco. 17-3, 49ers leading the Browns, 7:29 to go in the third. Obanaya. 5-yard gain for him, just short of the 20-yard line. Aerial coverage of today's game being provided by MetLife. Snoopy is joining us here today in the Bay Area. Just great pictures, Halloween weekend. Just a wide variety of costumes.
I love Halloween.
McCoy is dumped. Ahmad Brooks gets McCoy again. Well, Brooks has really found a niche with his San Francisco defense after being waived by the Bengals' designated pass rusher, and he's getting it done.
Well, he's using good timing, explosion. He gets by Obanaya, just overpowers Obanaya. And Colt McCoy again goes down. But how about this afternoon for Brooks? He got it started in that first quarter with the sack and the strip.
Son of the late Terry Brooks, who was an NFL defensive tackle with the Washington Redskins. Third and 10 now. Play fake. McCoy again underneath. And Alex Smith stays on his feet and turns it into a big gainer. So it's the Browns version of Alex Smith making a play. 20 yards on the catch and run.
He stepped right over the top of Dashon Goldson. Here he is in the backfield just coming out on a little flat route. Watch this athletic move right here. There's the hurdle, and it breaks the tackle, gets down the sidelines. This is imperative that the Browns get a touchdown now. That's their longest play of the afternoon, that 20-yarder by Alex Smith.
I'll take Smith for 200, Alex. It would be a bigger upset if there were two Isaac Sopoagas on each roster. McCoy up top connects with Benjamin Watson. So the tight ends are now contributing for Cleveland. And finally, the Browns looking downfield. Long completion, 29 yards for Pat Shurmur and company.
Yeah, back-to-back longest plays of the afternoon. McCoy gets great pass protection here. He eyes his tight end the whole way. And he's got his tight end for a big play.
And McCoy trying to find some rhythm here. Greg Little with a quick hitter of 4 yards, a modest gain as he is knocked down by Carlos Rogers, the former Washington Redskin.
Yeah, modest or immodest, it's a gain for the Browns. It's something that we haven't seen a lot of today, but you're talking about that rhythm. You saw how quickly McCoy got back, 3 steps, got it out to his receiver. That's the essence of this West Coast offense. Quick drops by the quarterback, getting the ball to his receivers in a hurry.
McCoy, 11 of 17, 121 yards. No touchdowns, no picks, and a timeout call. Shurmur came all the way out on the field to call the timeout. So the Browns will use their Candlestick Park, opened back in 1960. 49ers started playing here in 1971. Brown showing some signs of life on offense. They trail 17-3, 4:32 to go in the third. Deep drop, McCoy. McCoy steps up, throws, end zone. Intercepted. It's Goldson with the pick, trying to squeeze it into double coverage.
Yeah, big mistake by Colt McCoy. Got a great block from Chris Obanaya on Patrick Willis coming on the blitz. He steps up into the pocket, and I'm not sure what he's thinking. Now watch the blitz coming here, and the fine block by number 25, Obanaya. McCoy will step around it and then just Hail Marys it down the field. Look at that coverage. Perfect by Terrell Brown on the outside, Whitner on the inside. Second pick for Whitner this season. Rather, it's Dashon Goldson with his first pick of the year.
So McCoy trying to hit Little, and instead it's a turnover. 49ers have it at the 20. And a 14-point lead. Smith, protection holds up. And it glances off the fingertips of Bruce Miller. Incomplete. NFC West standings right now. San Francisco with a chance to clinch the division with a win today. Actually, no, that's mathematically impossible. But they are dominating the division. Seattle at 2-4, St. Louis 1-6, Arizona 1-6 as well.
And Seattle trailing Cincinnati up north.
Haps a four-game lead after seven games. It's unheard of.
Second and 10 now for the 49ers. Pitch to Hunter. Stiff arm and good help coming over. Sheldon Brown in run support with Chris Gokong initially slowing down Hunter, and it's a loss of four on the play. Cleveland, meanwhile, might be in the most competitive division in the NFL right now. The AFC North with Baltimore and Pittsburgh at 5-2, Cincinnati at 4-2, and there are the Browns at 3-3.
And Pittsburgh on top of New England right now. This is a heck of a division. We talked about all those great defenses. The top four coming into today's games.
Third and 14 now for the 49ers. Smith has thrown for 146 yards and try to hit Edwards. It's incomplete.
You just get a feeling that Dick Geron knows his defense has to make a play, has to create some type of turnover. He came with a blitz on all three of those three and outs for the 49ers. Very aggressive play calling by Geron, something the Browns need. Something else need right now is a good punt return from Joshua Cribbs.
Andy Lee will punt it. He's been busy in this second half. And Cribbs standing at his own 36-yard line. Off the snap from Jennings. Lee with a high sailing kick, and it sends Cribbs back to the 25. Got a block on that right side, and Cribbs trying to shed tacklers as he spins his way to the 43-yard line. 61-yard punt, a 17-yard return for Joshua Cribbs. Tuesday on CBS, a cop who remembers everything will stop at nothing to find a kidnapped child. Catch a new episode of the new hit drama, Unforgettable. That's Tuesday, only CBS.
You just get the feel the Browns are just hanging around. They're not getting taking advantage of some opportunities. A huge turnover by McCoy on that last possession for Cleveland, but good field position now. Like I said before, they've got to find a way to get in the end zone.
There's no doubt. It's Cleveland's defense that has gotten the team to 3-3. Now it's time for the offense to step forward and start making some plays and developing under Pat Shermer. It hasn't happened here today. 17-3 San Francisco. McCoy, and he's able to hit Jordan Norwood, getting more opportunities because of the injury to Massaqua. Chris Culliver with the stick, and it's a 6-yard gain through the air.
And yeah, Norwood has now been targeted four times. Surprise starter, but with Massaqua out, Pat Shermer deciding to go with Norwood, and Norwood's rewarding that decision.
Hard luck, hard luck.
Second and four for the Browns.
Hard luck.
McCoy, 127 yards through the air. And one interception in the last possession. McCoy, short drop. And try to hit Little again. Greg Little having a tough time. What's the scouting report from both McCoy and from Shermer? He said, look, he's raw. He's developing. He's learning. But he's got the body and he's got the skill set to be a successful wide receiver.
But, you know, he's playing against a defense that sees us every day in practice. The 49ers basically run the same type of offense. A lot of slant routes, a lot of short routes. And so for Terrell Brown, he's seen that route probably more than Greg Little has run that route.
Here comes the rush on third and four. McCoy steps up. McCoy tries a little fake, and McCoy, good toughness as he'll move the chains with a first down 5-yard scramble.
And Carlos Rogers can't believe he let a quarterback drag him for the first down. Heck of an effort by McCoy. It was man-to-man coverage by the 49ers because of the blitz. He breaks out, little pump fake there, and there's that surprising strength by McCoy and Desire.
And on the quick snap, Obanaya with a 4-yard pickup. Dante Whitner with the stop. 29 yards on the ground for Obanaya.
And this is not a hurry-up offense. It's a tempo type of offense, trying to increase the tempo, although now they're slowing it down by going back into the huddle. But that quick snap there got the Browns about 4 yards on first down.
They are playing without Peyton Hillis, out with a hamstring injury. Montario Hardesty, we saw him early, but looks like a calf injury has cost him playing time this afternoon. And it's been Chris Obanaya, second-year running back out of Texas. Obanaya, good cut out across the 40-yard line to the 39 for a 4-yard gain. And sets up third and a makeable 2 yards.
Yeah, Obanaya with a good cut there, but he kind of tripped over Sean Laval, his right guard, or he might have had big yardage.
There is Peyton Hillis, acquired in the Brady Quinn deal with the Denver Broncos, originally a seventh-round draft pick out of Arkansas in 2008. And Hardesty missed all of last season with a torn left ACL. Happened in the preseason in his rookie year out of Tennessee last year. 32. McCoy gets rid of it. Catch is made, but short of the first down. Obanaya, now they rule it incomplete. Patrick Willis with the hit.
Carlos Rogers came up quickly on that little sprint out. Again, the 49ers see this type of play all the time. This is just a sprint out to the right, halfback in the flat, and a good reaction by Carlos Rogers.
Yeah, Obanaya never had complete control of the ball as McCoy had to get rid of it. And on fourth down, the Browns elect to punt. Fourth and two. What do you think here?
Well, it's too long for a field goal. I wouldn't mind going for it on fourth down if I'm the Browns. Watch the fake here.
Maynard the punt. Ted Ginn looking into the sun, and he handles it at the 11-yard line. 28-yard punt with 29 seconds to go in the third. Tonight on 60 Minutes, what did Bernie Madoff's family know about the biggest financial fraud in history? You'll hear it all when his wife and son break their silence. On 60 Minutes, tonight, only CBS.
Yeah, you go back to that decision to not go for it on fourth and about three. Shermer likes the way his defense has been playing. He knows the 49ers have a long field to go, but he is down by 14. A lot of time left in this ball game. The Browns just hanging around, and I'm sure that's what Shermer's thinking about.
49ers only lost this season back on September the 18th, 27-24 to Dallas in overtime. On first down, handoff to Gore, and Gore brought down behind the line of scrimmage by DaQuell Jackson. What a season Jackson is having after suffering pectoral injuries each of the last 2 years. He's really got a nose for the ball. It's a loss of one on the play. And that'll do it for this third quarter. San Francisco in front of Cleveland. 17-3. We'll come back to Candlestick after this. We welcome you back to San Francisco. 49ers 17, the Browns 3. Whoa, that's not right.
There's no body with that head. That's scary.
Ian Eagle, Dan Fouts, the rest of our CBS crew. We start playing this fourth quarter. And the 49ers trying to get to 6-1 on the season. Fake the handoff. And it's going to be Smith. Oh, he takes a big shot from Usama Young. 9-yard gain for Alex Smith.
He'll be thinking twice about doing this again and not sliding sooner. Joe Hayden and Usama Young say hello.
Alex Smith, the number one pick in the 2005 draft.
Come on, let's go.
A lot of people around the league were shocked that he ended up re-signing with San Francisco. This is a big play on a third and two. Smith, timing route, and too high for Crabtree. Dimitri Patterson was beat on the play, and Smith unable to deliver the football on time to Crabtree.
Well, let's check out Crabtree. Here he is on the outside, working against Sheldon Brown. It's just a little fake, a little rub route there, working in tandem with the inside receiver. That was Ted Ginn, and he would like to have that one back.
So on fourth down, the Browns defense has held once again in this second half. 49ers have done very little offensively. Andy Lee with the punt. Cribbs backpedaling from the 16-yard line. Takes it straight ahead. And Cribbs able to keep those legs going to the 34-yard line. 65-yard punt. 14-point lead. The NFL on CBS has regional action. Big AFC East matchup. The Jets take on the Bills. The Browns will be in Houston. Tebow and the Broncos battle Carson Palmer and the Raiders. It all starts with the NFL Today, presented by Southwest Airlines at noon Eastern time right here on CBS. Chris Tabor, special teams coordinator for Cleveland. A call just went against his special teams unit on that return from Cribbs. A holding call has backed it up now. And his counterpart is Brad Seeley, who was formerly with the Cleveland Browns, and the 49ers have been amongst the best special teams units so far this season. Seeley also the assistant head coach of the 49ers under Jim Harbaugh.
That penalty against Titus Brown has cost the Browns 20 yards, very valuable yards.
So the ball spotted at the 8-yard line. Obanaya in the backfield. 17-3 San Francisco. Obanaya with a spin move. And able to carry to the 12 for a 4-yard gain. Jean Francois in on that stop for San Francisco. Just underway in this fourth quarter. 49ers have 300 yards of offense. The Browns have been held to 168. Cleveland came in as the number 23 ranked offense in the NFL. The 49ers have not allowed a 100-yard rusher in 28 consecutive games, the longest active streak in the league. McCoy gets rid of it, and Evan Moore hauls it in. Navarro Bowman with the stop.
This will bring up a very manageable third down. If he was short of that first down, it looks like Bill Levy wants to measure this one.
Inches. So third down now for the Browns. Pat Shurmur, 2 years offensive coordinator with St. Louis, 10 years with Philadelphia. As a quarterback's coach, tight end, offensive line. He actually served on that Andy Reid staff along with Jim Harbaugh's brother John when John was running the special teams of the Eagles. Now the head coach of the Baltimore Ravens, third and inches for the Browns.
Browns been pretty good this afternoon, 5 of 10 on third down conversions.
McCoy will push the pile himself and get the first down by a landslide. 3-yard gain. Well, the two coaches have some history together going back to the Big Ten days. Jim Harbaugh at Michigan and Pat Shurmur, offensive lineman for Michigan State. Let's take you back, October 1986.
Harbaugh misses the handoff and scores, just like Jim Harbaugh would, isn't it?
27-6, the Wolverines getting the win over the Riders.
McCoy recovered his own fumble coming away from center. That's three times today that McCoy has fumbled.
One of those he lost early in the game in the first quarter.
That was on a strip sack. Then he collided with his fullback, Owen Marisic. And this one, he just gets a short snap from Alex Mack. Can't afford to have these type of plays when you're down and you've got to get in the end zone.
Second and 10 now for the Browns. Swing it out for Obanaya. Tried that spin move on Navarro Bowman, and Bowman able to hold his positioning and come up with the tackle.
Bowman showing great speed too. That was a swing route to Obanaya, and you know that old saying about he who hesitates. Well, usually in the NFL, he who hesitates gets tackled. And that was Bowman.
So now third and 12 for the Browns. We'll hit the 11-minute mark of this fourth quarter. Smith goes in motion, sets up in front of Obanaya. Now McCoy in trouble. And McCoy is sacked. Alden Smith, the rookie out of Missouri, the number seven pick. 6.5 sacks on the season. He leads all NFC rookies in that category.
Now watch his speed on this sack, Ian. This is why he was the number one pick. Watch his speed as he comes all this way to get after the quarterback. Not many guys can run this far and then finish it off. Great play by Alden Smith.
And it forces Cleveland into a fourth down, and Brad Maynard once again. Ted Ginn from the 34. He's got room. Ginn stumbles a bit, but is able to get it out across midfield and into Cleveland territory. Ted Ginn, Cleveland native out of... Back here in San Francisco, the 49ers lead the NFL in most possessions starting in their opponent's territory. And you can tack on another one here for San Francisco. From the 48 of the Browns, hand off to Frank Gore. And Gore falls forward to the 44. Atava Rubin among those there. Gokong was able to get up on his own after getting injured on that last punt. So Kaluka Maiava has stepped in for Gokong at that outside linebacker position.
And that stat you talked about starting in your opponent's end of the field is because of great defense and superior special teams. That was a good return by Ted Ginn.
And Ted Ginn comes in second in the NFL in kickoff return average, fifth in punt return average. Second and six. Smith on the toss. Gore to Ginn, and it backfires. Daquell Jackson blows up that play for Cleveland defensively.
Great job by Daquell Jackson. Slow developing reverse. Here is Ginn. He's going to come around here. And from the inside, you'll see Daquell Jackson on a run blitz. He sees it all the way and from behind brings down the speed again. 8-yard loss.
So a third and 14 now. Jackson comes in as the leading tackler for the Browns this season, averaging 9 tackles per game. Here's Smith stepping up. He fires, incomplete. Two receivers in the area, Ginn and Edwards. And another 3-and-out for the San Francisco offense. As sharp as they looked in the first half, they have done very little in this second half against the Cleveland D.
And it's got to be puzzling to that man, Jim Harbaugh. But you got to give a lot of credit to Dick Geron's defense. They're hanging in there. Just hoping that Cribbs can make a play. They can get something going on offense.
Shoulder injury for Chris Gokong. His return is questionable. Fifth punt. And 4 of the 5 have been 3-and-outs from the 49ers. Andy Lee. And this one will end up in the end zone. Touchback. Browns will have it at the 20 with 8:41 to play. 17-3. 49ers maintaining
the CBS.
Halloween weekend here in the city by the bay. San Francisco 17, Cleveland 3. And the Browns get the football back with 8:41 to go in the fourth quarter. 168 yards of offense for Cleveland. McCoy scrambling. And McCoy stays on his feet and goes down before he takes a shot. It'll be short of a first down. Patrick Willis missed initially, and it turns into a 9-yard gain.
And the Browns are going to go right to the line of scrimmage, try to up the tempo. It's been a rough day for Colt McCoy hanging onto the ball. Ahmad Brooks and his own fullback runs into him on that play. Obanaya with the fumble. And now the Browns back on offense.
Second and one, and McCoy will run for it. So they'll move the chains as he takes it to the 33-yard line, 4-yard pickup.
McCoy is a competitor, and you're seeing it right now as he's trying to rally his team with his legs. Pick up that first down.
McCoy throws it underneath, and drop ball by Obanaya. McCoy telling us that it is a process with him and Pat Shurmur week to week trying to figure out what Shurmur likes and what he wants out of the quarterback position, getting a feel for Shurmur's play calling. And he believes that they are now on the same page. Although today it has been rough for this Cleveland offense to find any kind of flow offensively, at least through the air. 130 yards passing on 14 of 24 for McCoy. Second and 10. Slant. And that's how they get Little involved. Forward progress to the 42-yard line. That's short of a first down. Navarro Bowman with the stop.
And again, they'll go right to the line of scrimmage. And I like that type of strategy. Time is running down. You're still down by 14, just 7.5 minutes to go. You've got to do this. You just can't afford to take more time off the clock.
A few weeks ago, they were out here in Oakland playing the Raiders, and it was a mad dash in the fourth quarter trying to come from behind. Oakland ended up holding on for the win. Third and one. Rush coming, and McCoy, low throw, trying to hit Obanaya. And now it's fourth down with 7:09 left.
Yeah, Vic Fangio, the defensive coordinator for the 49ers, bringing the blitz. Ahmad Brooks and Navarro putting the pressure.
They're going to go for it on fourth down. And they need a full yard here. And McCoy trying to get it himself.
He got it with third effort that time. He was stoned once the ball was snapped. Bowman was right up in the middle there. 49ers pinching down with both Justin Smith and DeMarcus Dobbs. You can see they thought the quarterback sneak was coming. Look at Whitner going high, preventing McCoy from going over the top.
Boy, they did not get a very good spot. It looks like it's going to be enough for the first down either way, but it looked like McCoy had gotten it well past that spot. So with 6:55 to go on the fourth, this drive continues for the Browns, trailing 17-3. Since coming back into the league, no Browns quarterback has started all 16 games in a season. Colt McCoy trying to prove this year that he deserves this job down the road. And McCoy connects with Evan Moore into San Francisco territory, and a first down for the Browns. Patrick Willis brings down the tight end with help from Goldson, 11-yard gain. Clock is moving, 6.5 left in the fourth. From the gun, McCoy, sideline, it's caught by Cribbs and breaks free for the touchdown. McCoy to Cribbs, 46 yards, and the Browns battling back.
Working against Terrell Brown on the outside, just a go route and a perfect throw by Colt McCoy. Longest reception of the year for Josh Cribbs, and just what the Browns needed. It's double coverage. Brown lets him go. Goldson is late coming over. And how about the power of Cribbs to break the tackle and score?
Just over 6 minutes to play, and the Browns an extra point away from cutting this to a 7-point San Francisco lead. Dawson on.
And with the way their defense is playing, no need for an onside kick at this point.
Agreed. Defense has kept them in it.
You're going to see if perhaps Cribbs may have stepped out of bounds. They're reviewing it upstairs. He's in there. He's all the way in.
He is all the way in to the end zone. They're going to take a look at it, but this one seems pretty obvious.
NFL on CBS is sponsored by New Line Cinema's A Very Harold and Kumar 3D Christmas in theaters November 4th. And by Subway Restaurants. It's Anytober. This October, any footlong is a $5 footlong.
8 plays, 80 yards for the Cleveland Browns. Bill Levy.
Confirmed it is a touchdown.
Thank you for the confirmation. Key play was on fourth and one when McCoy was able to get the first down and keep the drive going, and then the big play to Cribbs for the touchdown down the sideline, and Dawson on for the extra point to cut it to 7. Seven. 17-10, 49ers, 6:17 remaining on the clock. McCoy now 17 of 28, 196 yards, a touchdown and a pick.
Let's go back to the touchdown. You see how Ben Watson's pass route here will affect this man here. That's Goldson. Brown is expecting help over the top. That's why he lets Cribs go down the sidelines. But as Watson comes across right here, you can see just that hesitation by Goldson, enough for Cribs to get behind Brown for the score. Good recognition by McCoy to see Cribs down the sidelines. And how about the catch under pressure and then the strength to pull away for the score by Cribs. And a little Halloween dance.
So the Cleveland Browns, a 6-3 win last week over Seattle. Defense obviously did tremendous work in the limited action because the Browns held onto the football so long. But it's clear the defense has kept them in the game here today. And then the offense comes up with a critical play. Now they'll hand it over to the defense once again to see if they can stop San Francisco. 49ers so good in this first half with Smith and Gore combining. Dawson kicking off to Ted Ginn. Ginn bobbles a bit. Ginn running lane, closed up in a hurry. And he is brought down to the 25-yard line by Young on special teams. For those of you expecting to see 60 Minutes, you're watching the NFL on CBS. Game between the Browns and the 49ers. Ian Eagle along with Dan Fouts. Our score, San Francisco 17, Cleveland 10. 60 Minutes will be seen immediately after the game, except on the West Coast, where it will be seen at its regularly scheduled time. Tonight, Bernie Madoff's wife and son featured on 60 Minutes. 49ers with a first and 10. Hand off to Gore, and he runs into a large crowd and a one-yard gain for Gore. Let's check out the game summary. It happened early on defense for San Francisco, forcing the fumble, and then they turned it into 7 points with Gore. But just moments ago, McCoy hooking up with Cribs down the sideline to bring the Browns to within seven.
A great defense by the Browns in the second half. They've allowed 49ers just 44 yards and only 6 yards here in the fourth quarter.
Gore over 100 in the first half, held in check in the second half, and it's a second and 9. Smith to Gore. At Frank Gore. Atava Rubin with a stop, a 6-yard gain. A couple of turnovers for the Browns. Gore, fourth straight 100-yard rushing game. He's moved into second place on the 49ers all-time rushing list, passing Roger Craig and Alex Smith. Good times continuing for Smith and consistent play. Smith now with 9 touchdowns and just 2 interceptions on the season.
This is a critical third down for both teams.
White.
Under 5 minutes to play. Third and 3 for the Niners.
Yeah.
Smith working from the gun. Inside handoff. Gore is stopped and a flag down. Two of them. DeQuell Jackson able to bring down Gore.
May have brought him down by a face mask. That's what Gore is trying to plead.
Face mask.
It is.
52 defense. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Good call, Dan.
Really unfortunate for DeQuell Jackson. He saw the play the whole way. Trying to make a tackle. Reaches out and all he can really grab for is Gore's face mask. There you see the grab right there. You know, if he doesn't grab the face mask, Gore will pick up the first down anyway.
So a desperate reaction there from Jackson. Niners get the first down out near midfield. 4:41 to go in the fourth. And a fresh set of downs for San Francisco to work with. Cleveland does have 2 timeouts remaining and, of course, the 2-minute warning. Smith, quick one to Edwards. First down, San Francisco. On the slant, 13 yards. Braylon Edwards is back after having surgery for a torn meniscus in his right knee.
Yeah, with his size, he's the perfect type of receiver with that body to run the slant route. He can shield the defender away from him. But I'm wondering why Sheldon Brown was playing so far off and so far to the outside. That was a gimme for Alex Smith and Braylon Edwards.
Edwards signing a one-year deal with San Francisco when the Jets moved on, signing Plexico Burress to replace him. So Aga is in the game, and another extra lineman, handoff to Gore. Power formation, and Gore is a power runner. Inside, Gore picks up extra yardage just on effort. Six-yard gain for Frank Gore.
49ers finally getting something going here thanks to that face mask penalty and the pass route to Braylon Edwards. You can see that just been miserable here in the second half. But not only did the 49ers bring in an extra offensive lineman on that play, Ian, they went unbalanced, strong to the right. So a lot of power for Gore to run behind.
And don't forget, 60 Minutes is coming up immediately following our coverage, except here on the West Coast, where it will be seen at its normally scheduled time. Second and four. It's Gore, and he is hit by Rubin. Ataba Rubin, all 6'2", 330 pounds of him, brings down Gore in a timeout taken by the Browns. 3:11 to play now in this fourth quarter. Well, the last time the 49ers beat the Browns, let's take you back. October 1990, Joe Montana to Jerry Rice. Browns trying to come back with Mike Pagel to Ozzie Newsome. But Mike Kofor, the game winner, 45 yards with 5 seconds left. 20-17, San Francisco with the win.
Can you ever get enough of watching Montana throw to Rice?
No.
It's just a thing of beauty, wasn't it?
Montana and Rice, both represented here inside Candlestick. Hall of Famers. Great memories. Bill Walsh, former coach of yours.
I worked with Bill in 1976 before he took the Stanford job for the first time. And when he took the Stanford job for the first time, it broke my heart. As I had seen his success with Kenny Anderson and Greg Cook in Cincinnati, he came out to San Diego and just spent one short year with me. And I owe him a lot for turning my game around.
Second and four here for the 49ers. Smith. Swing pass, and catch is made, Sopo Aga! First down for San Francisco. Earlier we saw Staley, now it's Sopo Aga. Jim Harbaugh getting everybody involved here.
Yeah, Staley caught one earlier. Here he is right here. He's in motion. That's 330 pounds of motion here. And again, a great pass by Smith. Nice and soft, right to the body. And Sopo Aga with a huge gain, and that could do it for the Brownies.
3:05 left. Cleveland with one timeout remaining. Handoff, Gore. Got that stutter step move, but he can just plow through that line of scrimmage and turned it into a solid gainer. Browns take a timeout with an even 3 minutes to play. Gives us time to check in with JB and Shannon in New York.
With number 12 at the helm for New England, you're never out of it, Shannon.
Now for fourth down pass interference called to keep the New England Patriots drive alive. Tom Brady retreat, find Aaron Hernandez, 1 yard touchdown. 23-17 onside kick was unsuccessful. Pittsburgh have the ball.
2:35 left in regulation. Back to Ian Eagle and Dan Fouts.
Well, we knew New England and Pittsburgh had a chance to be a pretty good one today. Browns trying to fight back against the San Francisco 49ers, but the Cleveland defense, which has been stellar in this second half, has finally taken some hits on this last San Francisco drive.
Yeah, the key play on this drive was the face mask penalty against DeQuell Jackson on a third and about three.
So it'll be second and six now for the 49ers. Trying to go undefeated in the month of October for the first time since 1997. On second down, it's Gore trying to find a crack. And Gore is hit after a one-yard gain. Clock will roll. Browns can't stop the clock. It won't stop until the two-minute warning. Schedule coming up for the San Francisco 49ers. They will be at Washington. And then the Giants and Arizona, back-to-back home games before heading back to the East Coast to meet the Baltimore Ravens. Thanksgiving, Harbaugh against Harbaugh.
I wonder how that handshake will be.
I think that one will be okay.
I'm not so sure.
They'll use a timeout.
They are brothers, you know.
Jim and John. John, a couple of years older than Jim. John's had success with the Baltimore Ravens. Jim, a lot of success at Stanford and the University of San Diego. He's actually an assistant coach with the Oakland Raiders for a couple of years and was an unpaid assistant for his dad at Western Kentucky. His father, Jack Harbaugh.
And very creative this afternoon. A lot of distribution for the 49ers. But who expected Joe Staley? He goes 17 yards with that one, and it just moments ago, Isaac Sopawaga down the sidelines and smartly steps out of bounds. You think he would might have leaned into the defender yeah. there and punished him and going for the end zone.
Well, just some background. Staley is a former tight end, and Sopawaga was a rugby player as a kid.
Well, you know what that has created now for Jim Harbaugh? Headaches.
Well, everybody's going to want to
well,
be a part
and
of
especially they want more.
Oh, they want more.
Hey, come on, coach. I'm one for one. I want more of the game plan.
Well, now they have tape. They can actually show the coach tape.
And they can show other teams around the league in case they, you know, want to go free agent.
2:14 to play now in this fourth quarter. Third and five for the 49ers. Fake the handoff. Smith looking. Smith will run and slide down. There is no reason to force the football and put yourself in a potential interception situation. So we'll hit the two-minute warning with San Francisco in front. 17-10 here in the fourth. Yes. Halloween set for tomorrow. San Francisco hoping to celebrate with a 6-1 record. They now have a 26-yard field goal in front of them with David Akers. And a chance to go up two scores with 2 minutes to go. And Akers converts for a 20-10 lead. 49ers in front. 1:56 remaining on the clock. Well, that face mask call, DeQuell Jackson grabbing Frank Gore, giving them the first down, and then San Francisco able to use up more clock and eventually get the field goal. Well, we've gotten reaction from our fans. They said we want more Fouts. December 11, 1982. Only NFL game in San Francisco. Fouts goes for 444 passing yards, 5 touchdowns, and the final touchdown to Chuck Muncy. You were hit on the play as well. Chargers win it 41-37. Now, the fans said we want more Fouts. They meant Bob Fouts.
Well, the big thing about that game is that quarterback on the other side was, he kept scoring.
Yeah, who was that?
That Montana guy.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, whenever you play against a guy like that, you got to pick up your game. And I had a lot of help that day. Wes Chandler with a couple of touchdown catches. But it was a great afternoon here in San Francisco, coming back and beating Bill Walsh and the great 49er team. And especially doing it here in my hometown.
What happened on that last play?
Touchdown. Well.
Did you see it?
I heard the crowd moan. You know, didn't see it at all. I was on my back. Clapping.
Just because you could sense you made the right play. So the Browns down 20-10. Akers kicks it off to Cribs. Cribs with a head of steam. And he's brought down at the 25-yard line by Gooden on special teams. Some numbers around the league. Roethlisberger goes for 365. Eli Manning, 349 yards and 2 touchdowns. Flacco with big passing numbers, but no touchdowns. Cam Newton continues to impress. Steven Jackson with 159 yards on the ground, 2 touchdowns. St. Louis gets the win. There is Frank Gore.
Arian Foster, who the Browns will be seeing next week in Houston with another big day.
How about Anquan Boldin, 145 for Baltimore. So Cleveland with the football. First and 10 at the 25. They have a minute 51 to work with, and they're down 10. McCoy, toss to the outside. Obanaya with the catch, and hit by Chris Culliver. It's a 7-yard gain.
How valuable has Chris Obanaya been today for the Browns? Ontario Hardesty gets hurt in the first quarter. Peyton Hillis didn't even suit up today. So it's all been Obanaya in the backfield for the Browns, and he's responded well.
Browns will be traveling to Houston next. Then they'll be home for St. Louis. It's a Cleveland team that went 5-11 last year, made changes. Certainly upgrades on defense. That's been evident. McCoy gets rid of it. And Norwood with a flag down. And it's right where McCoy was hit.
Personal
by Justin
foul,
Smith.
Roughing the passer, number 94 defense. Blow to the head, 15 yards, first down.
So extra yardage here for the Browns.
Well, Justin Smith, who's got 4.5 sacks on the year, comes in, and they see him lead with his helmet right into the jaw of Colt McCoy. Good call by Bill Levy.
And they'll place the football right at the 50-yard line with 1:38 remaining on the clock. Working out of the shotgun, McCoy, a couple of pumps, and he squeezes it in for Benjamin Watson. Watson to the 31-yard line. That covers 19 yards. Browns picking up chunks of yards in a hurry.
And fans are saying, where has this been all day long? Of course, the 49ers playing a lot of prevent, only rushing three at McCoy.
Just over a minute left. McCoy, rainbow, end zone, incomplete. Josh Cribbs matched up with Terrell Brown once again. Cribbs won the last battle to get the touchdown. So San Francisco holding on to a 20-10 lead over Cleveland. Frank Gore, 134 yards and a touchdown, his fourth straight game with 125-plus rushing yards and a new career high with 31 carries. Second and 10 for the Browns. 1:10 left to play. McCoy, pocket is crumbling, and McCoy is down. Patrick Willis. McCoy trying to get up. Loss of three on the play. Under a minute left now. Third and 13 for the Browns. McCoy trying to get him lined up. Down to 48 seconds left. From the gun. McCoy in trouble. Ball is stripped. McCoy scoops it up. McCoy looping the other way and throws to Obanaya. And Obanaya stays inbounds, and the clock continues to roll down to 28 seconds left. Paris Harrelson knocked the ball loose, and McCoy was able to have the presence of mind to recover it and keep the play going.
That's three fumbles of his own. He's recovered today.
Face.
Down to 15 seconds left. It's fourth down for Cleveland.
Ring.
And they're down by 10. Shotgun McCoy over the middle, too little. They'll pad their stats, but that's about it. San Francisco improves to 6-1. A 5-game winning streak for the 49ers. The first time since 2001. San Francisco continues its impressive run with a 20-10 win over Cleveland. Let's